I guess I'm live. What is up, gamers? The game should say Pack and Roll Remix, my bad. But, the game on stream anyways. But anyways, this is Pack and Roll Remix, part of the Namco Museum Remix and Namco Museum Mega Mix compilations for the Wii. It is an updated version of the original Pack and Roll, the DS game released in 2005. And, there's a lot to unpack in this game, especially because you've probably never seen this game before, so let's just go ahead and get started in 3, 2, 1, video games. So, the main movement tech in this game, aside from just rolling around, obviously, is, we have this little boost that you get just by shaking the Wii remote. It propels Pac-Man in the direction you're holding on the control stick, and you can use it to, like, break open boxes and obviously gain speed and also get a huge amount of height when going off of steep inclines, which I'll use a few times throughout this run. There's also a brake feature in this game you can have by pressing the Z button, which will halt Pac-Man in place and will stop him from getting recoiled back, and I'll be using that in various situations throughout the run. So that's the first level done. For the most part, these levels are just going to be me going through and collecting enough pack dots to open these Galvis gates. The routing is kind of all figured out, so expect some strangeness with routing. But yeah, as you're seeing there, I was using the brake mechanic to stop Pac-Man's momentum so that I could then boost in another direction. It's not often you'll see me use that because it's very hard for a human to control, but if you watch the task of this game by Elomavi, which I would recommend watching immediately after this run, they do that all over the place, and it's absolutely nuts to watch. The movement in this game, the skill ceiling in this game is way higher than I'm making it look. So here you're going to be seeing me use another instance of the brake mechanic. So there's various boxes that I said you can boost to, but you can get a lot of recoil normally when you hit them, but by braking, I can avoid that recoil and can move a lot quicker. Also, I just missed two pack dots in this level, and those are the only two spare ones I have. Most of the routes in this game are not very forgiving, but some are a bit more lenient than others, but we made it work out. I'll also be using it just to make sure I don't accidentally boost Pac-Man off the edge of a platform, or not get knocked back by a wall or something. So, here in 1-4 we have Night Pack, which is the first of the two power-ups in this game. Basically, it makes Pac-Man heavier, so you can't get him so much height from stuff, and he's also a bit slower, but he can break through those metal boxes, which normal Pac-Man can't do, and he can also go underwater. Pretty much any time he's in a level, I'm gonna need to grab him for one reason or another. Yeah, there's a ton of out-of-the-way areas in this level, but the goal of any percent is to just get to the goal as quickly as possible, so we go as little out of our way to collect pack dots in these levels as possible. And in this level, I'm actually supposed to be introduced to the other power-up in this game, Light Pack, but I'm actually going to skip grabbing it intentionally, because Normal Pack moves slightly faster on the ground than Light Pack, so I can make a slightly faster platform cycle at the end that saves about 8 seconds. So, Light Pack makes Pac-Man's physics very broken. He can last a lot longer in midair, and he also gets a lot of height from like slope boosts and stuff. And you'll be seeing that very shortly and how that can be exploited. Alright, so that's World 1 done. Now it's time for World 2. So, right at the start here, I'm going to be grabbing Light Pack. I'm going to actually go out of my way to do this, but you'll see why here shortly. Because with Light Pack, I can actually do this slope boost to get up to the end of the level, which you're not supposed to do at this point. Then I can ledge grab hop over here, and then do a ledge grab hop from here, and get into the goal platform without opening the gate. So that's the first gate skip of the run, and that saves about 35 seconds over doing the level the intended way. In 2-2, we're introduced to these bounce pad platforms, and I can use them for some small skips here, such as right here. And then there's boost pads here that allow me to go a bit faster and get to the next section quicker. And I'm going to be doing that again here in a little bit. So you can actually technically skip the gate in this level as well, but it's currently task only. You normally need this Light Pack card to get to the end of the level, but it's just barely possible to slow boost to these final two bounce pad platforms as Normal Pack, and it has currently not been pulled off without the use of tool assistance. And this level is just an absolute tease. So the goal platform is actually located right behind where you start, but there's actually no way to slow boost to it from the beginning. And the worst part is, you can actually skip this level in the DS version, but not in this version. I actually have to play through the entire level in this version. The skip would save, like, over a minute if it was possible, though, because this is one of the longest levels in the game, and also I do have to collect a lot of hack dots. Most of the routing in these levels, again, is just going as little out of the way to collect hack dots as possible, and also in a way that requires me to do as little backtracking. So you'll see that in this section right here, I'm gonna hopefully barely be able to have to go out of my way here, although I think I'm a hack dot or two short. Yeah, I'm like one hack dot short, so I'm just gonna have to get some from over there. Optimally, I wouldn't have to go to the right there, which is kind of what I'm talking about in terms of routing. And now here we have the bull. I'm just gonna kind of go from the outside in. And bull is interesting because we used to not have a consistent way to get out of here. It used to be kind of a 50-50 guess as to which direction is the right way to go. But then I discovered that you just gotta look at where that power pellet is and go to a little bit to the right of it, and you'll get out every single time. So yeah, unfortunately, one of the longer levels in the game, and yeah, this is right behind the beginning of the level, but no way to get to it early. Also, you don't want to fall off there. I once did that in a world record run a few years ago. So this is the first boss fight against Galvis, who's the main antagonist of the original Hack and Roll. There's no real exposition for him in this game. But the way these fights work is the same every time. Basically, you just eat 3 power pellets to make Galvis vulnerable, and then you eat him, and you have to do this 3 times in total. The power pellets will always appear in the same spots, so I know where they're going to be ahead of time. Although, in this fight, when I get to the third power pellet, I'm actually going to wait for Galvis to get closer to me, otherwise I will have to chase him down, and that could lose time. And right here I have Night Pack, so I could get that, mainly so I could get that metal box out of my way, but also so that I can get this power pellet a little bit easier, because it's kind of underwater. And it doesn't really matter, because I'm going to have to wait when I get to the end here, for Galvis to show up. And there we go, that's World 2. And now we're on to World 3, Sweet Land. So this level is a pretty big reset point early on in the run, because there is a platform cycle after the first gate in this level that's about 40 seconds into the level that basically requires me to only have like a couple seconds of leeway in my movement throughout this entire first section of the level. Also, with the way this route works out, I actually can't miss a single pack dot in this first section of the level. And what's really annoying is these ghosts. Ghost movement is completely RNG in this game, and as you just saw there, they can sometimes just be in your way. Thankfully, in this game, you have a health bar, as you see down in the lower right-hand corner. And so, when you touch a ghost, they doesn't instantly kill you, but they can kind of block your way and knock you back, and knock you off these platforms, and it can be really annoying, but we made it through okay. And now here, I'm gonna grab Light Pack, and I need to use this car to get to these platforms so I can get some pack dots, but now I can just kind of skip it for the rest of the stage by just ledge grab hopping between these platforms. Oh, okay, that's actually fine. So I wanted to get to that platform to get those pack dots, but there's a backup for it. I can just use slow boosting to get up here, and then I can grab some extra pack dots from over here with a ledge grab hop. Yeah, so if I actually didn't fall off there, I would have had just enough pack dots to finish the level after clearing those out, but that didn't lose too much time, only like a couple seconds at best. And now here, there's a variety of different ways I can go about the start of this level. Also, these ghosts are an absolute pain to get past, but they were very cooperative there, and I got a slow boost, which is nice. Alright, I need that pack dot. Okay, got it. I'm gonna grab that Night Pack card on the way back, because I'm gonna need to grab some underwater pack dots in order to have enough to open the gate. And yeah, that's what I was talking about. Sometimes you just don't get momentum there, and then you run into the ghost and lose all your speed. So coming up is a normal pack card I'm actually gonna grab. You can actually skip grabbing this normal pack card, and then you would skip having to eat Blinky in the next section. But normal pack moves so much faster than Night Pack, it's actually worth it to go ahead and grab that, and then spend a little bit of time here eating Blinky in the next section. So I'm just gonna have to go out of my way here to grab that. And then I need Night Pack, because there's a metal box I need to break through in order to get to the end of the level. There we go. So now we got 3-3. This level is pretty much mostly based around cycles, and if you have good movement, getting the optimal cycles here is pretty lenient. And I'm going to use Light Pack for most of this level. In this first section, I only have one spare pack dot, so that's the only one I can miss. But again, you have a fair amount of leeway with cycles in this level, so I usually finish the stage at around the same time every time. And here I'm just going to kind of minimize the amount of time I spend waiting on these platforms. So something I should probably talk about is the NG Plus rules in this game. You probably notice I already have all the levels unlocked, and I have 7 bars of health. You would normally start with 3. Because Namco Museum Mega Mix autosaves, it would be a pain to have to wipe your memory every single time you would want to do runs. And it would also be a pain to just not save, to just select it so that it doesn't autosave. So it's allowed to have everything kind of already locked, because nothing changes in the base game versus when you complete it versus when you don't complete it. So that's why I have the hidden pizzas all collected that unlock the extra bars of health, and that's why I have all the stages already unlocked, because it doesn't really matter. Yeah, I made all the optimal cycles there. Nothing too crazy about that level. You just gotta not miss any cycles and not die. So now in 3-4, I'm going to try to be kind of stingy with pack dots here, because they're, something that's very important at the end of this level. Basically, there is a roller coaster ride that I have to go on, because there's no way to skip the final gate of the level. Therefore, I need the pack dots from the roller coaster in order to actually unlock the final gate. If I reach the number of pack dots required to open the gate, by the way, I'm just going in here to ditch night pack, because again, normal pack moves so much faster. If I get to the number of pack dots I need to open the gate and then die, I can respawn at the checkpoint right in front of the gate and still have all 80 pack dots remaining. And so the reason why you don't want to miss too many pack dots here is because you can die earlier. So I missed 2, which isn't great, but I can still reap a decent amount of time save from this. So here's the auto-scroller, and again, I just kind of have to wait here. This is literally one of the only portions of downtime in the entire run. This section's obviously a pain in when you're in the all pack dots category, because if you miss a pack dot here, you have to redo this roller coaster, and it's really terrifying. So we're coming up on that 80 pack dot count. As you can see, in the lower left-hand corner, that's how many pack dots I need to open each gate. And the upper left-hand corner is how many pack dots are currently in my inventory. So I'm going to jump off and die now. And I still have my pack dots, so I can feed them to this gate. And there we go. So because my life count changed from when I started the level, the game's auto-saving here. And that also happens if you beat an IL timer update a score of any time. And auto-saving wastes about 4.5 seconds usually, so I want to minimize that as much as possible. Which is why you might see me sometimes wait at the end of the level before actually going into the gold platform. So this is the World 3 boss fight. I would argue this is one of the scariest fights in the run, because it's super easy to fall off and die here, especially in the second phase. But that was perfect. And now here I'm basically gonna grab the power pots at specific times to manipulate Galvis into staying stunned so that he doesn't knock me off the stage. And there we go. That's World 3. Now it's time for World 4. So the Ghost Land is not in this version of the game. We just go straight to Flaming Fortress. So War 1 has a skip that was discovered fairly recently that has never been pulled off RTA. But for the sake of the marathon, I'm actually going to try it. This allows, if I can get this, this will allow me to skip the last 2 gates of the level. And it involves a technique called slow boosting, bounce boosting, which I'll explain later. Because you'll see this later, but I'm gonna give this a shot. I didn't get it. So, I could try it again. It doesn't necessarily lose a whole ton of time to go for it, so that's why I kind of went for it. But I am gonna miss a couple of platform cycles because of that. This level is normally a pain anyway, so because it's super easy to just kind of get bounced all over the place. So yeah, if I did that skip right, I would have done a huge bounce with a huge amount of momentum and ended up in this section, and I could skip the last 2 gates, but we didn't get that, so we're gonna lose about, like, 20 seconds or so. There we go. Again, that skip has never been pulled off in a run, so it's not surprising that I didn't get it. It's the hardest strat in the game that can be done by humans. So this level is mostly pretty straightforward, just a bunch of obstacles that are in your way. There's going to be some damage abuse later, so that I can use invincibility frames to damage boost through them, like right here. This is another level where there are gate skips that are theoretically possible, so I'm grabbing Light Pack here just to skip some of these bounce pad platforms. If you keep Light Pack for the remainder of this level, you can actually skip the last two gates of this level by just boosting around them. But it is currently, it's another skip that has currently never been pulled off by a human. And the skip saves so little time, and it's basically just the only time save you get is from not having to go out of your way to collect pack dots because this level's so linear based. Oh, wow. I have actually never fallen off the edge like that. Can I get it? That's never happened before? But yeah. Another thing is that most Galvis gates in this game have invisible walls surrounding them that also extend upwards by quite a bit. So, skipping them is easier said than done in most instances, especially in this level where you have wimps around the edges of the gates that prevents you from making it all the way over. So that's why I'm not just jumping around every single gate, because it's usually not possible. Nice. So 4-3 doesn't really matter how fast I play here, because I'm bound by a platform cycle after the first gate. You cannot make this cycle RTA. TAS obviously makes that cycle because it's insane, but here you have to wait for this one. Luckily, it's a pretty generous cycle. This is coming up is probably one of my favorite sections of the run movement-wise, and you'll see why very shortly. First, I have to boost into these bounce pads to get enough momentum to make it all the way across. And here's my favorite section of the run. Get recoiled back from that bounce pad right there, and then I can boost off to the second bounce pad like that. And that saves a couple seconds. I just gotta get it to 55 pack dots, and there we go. A little bit slower than I would've liked, but still made it out alright. Alright, now we're getting to the late game run enders of this category. So this level is kind of just a long downward spiraling path. So Pac-Man dies when he falls for a long enough distance without being above valid flooring. So you're probably asking, why don't you just fall from higher sections of the level to lower sections and do big skips? That's because the distances in this level are too large. We don't exactly understand how the mechanics work, but basically, Pac-Man just dies if he falls too far without being above valid flooring. And in this level, that you can't mitigate that in any way, so there's no way to skip sections of this level. This is actually one of the scariest levels in the run, because as you can see, there's a lot of boosting, especially around these tight turns. And if you hold the slightest wrong angles or get caught on geometry in the slightest wrong way, you'll just launch off the stage and die. And checkpoints are pretty sparse in this level, so dying here basically is a run ender. So, coming up in the next level, I'm going to talk about, you're going to be seeing a lot more bounce boosting, which is a trick I went for in 4-1 but didn't get. So, basically, if you boost at the exact same time that you're grounded on a bounce pad or lava, you have to do it on the first frame you're grounded, you can actually enter a boost state while you're on the bounce pad, and this can preserve some momentum and allow you to enter a boost state. And I'm going to be using that in this level both on bounce pads and also on lava in order to do some pretty nice sequence breaks. This is also going to be a level where I have to keep track of my health, and we're having the extra bars of health from the pizzas really comes in handy. So I currently do not have any faster way to do this section consistently. If you want to come up with one, be my guest. So here's the only gate in the level, so now here I'm going to utilize bounce boosting. It's frame perfect as far as we know, and motion control dependent, so it's really fun. And I just made it look easy. So here I'm going to use it. There's a ton of these falling towers that you normally have to climb, but using lava boosting I could skip pretty much all of them. I'm going to go for another bounce boost here. There we go. I can probably make this cycle. Alright, so this is actually the fastest cycle you can make in the level. I was a little bit later than I would have been optimal, but still good. And now I can just lava boost around that last set of falling towers, and that's the level. And now it's time for the World 4 boss. And this boss is kind of RNG, especially this first phase, because he rotates the platform one of three different ways, but you can mitigate it by just slow boosting to the power pellets. And Galvis is a pain to catch. Here, I'm gonna try a strat where I slope boost to this bottom left power pellet early. And I got it. So, oh, but I unfortunately missed this power pellet, so I'm gonna try lava boosting to it. There we go. So if I didn't miss that Powerathon, I would have been able to finish that second phase a little bit quicker. And I also would have been able to start this phase before the platform finishes stabilizing, which would allow me to get the three power pellets a little bit quicker, but instead I just had to do that. There we go. That wasn't too great. But now it's on to World 5. This is actually exclusive to the Wii version of the game, and every single level in this world has a big skip. Contrary to the first four worlds, where only two levels had big skips. So, 5-1 in TAS is actually the fastest level in the game, because you can just... There's a TAS setup where you can boost straight to the gold platform from the start as normal pack, but that setup is currently not humanly viable. But there is a setup with light pack that's humanly viable, so I have to go through this first gate, but, to get light pack, and here I can use the slip boost that allow me to get around some wonky collision, and, get to the corner of this gold platform. This saves about 50 seconds and skips the second and third gates of the level, like that. And now in 5-2 and 5-3, the distances between platform heights are actually small enough to where I can just kind of fall between various gaps and skip huge chunks of this level. And this is another level with a gate skip. I'm gonna use a glitchy ledge bounce here. Oh. Hopefully. There we go. So just bounce up to the gold platform early. And this level is extremely difficult and extremely long. So next up is 5-4, and this level actually has a gate skip that is done in world record runs, but for marathon safety, I'm not going to go for it because it only saves about 10 seconds, and if you fail it, you die and lose way more time than the skip actually saves, and it's really precise. So I'm just going to opt out of doing it and do this much safer route that's barely any slower. There's still a lot of really cool tricks in this level, especially a bunch of cycle skips as you're seeing here. So yeah, the skip would basically be you just boost around this gate to those pink and blue platforms behind me. Alright. There is another big skip at the end of this level, though. So there's going to be some... After an upcoming checkpoint, there's going to be some light pack cards in front of a bounce pad, and I can use the light pack cards and the bounce pad to basically jump straight to the final gear of the level. This saves about 25 to 30 seconds. It is kind of cycle-dependent, though, but I have timer cues for when to go. There we go. And now we are off to the final boss. So this final boss is actually in two phases. This first phase is just kind of going to be me kind of boosting around. This is pretty scary because it's super easy to die if you hold the slight wrong angles. So while we're here, If you want to learn this game, you should join the Pac-Man Speedrunning Discord. I am currently the only person who takes this game seriously, but I would love for there to be a bigger community for this game, so if you really want to learn this game, get in contact with me. I have an entire tutorial for any percent that's still fairly relevant. And, yeah. I really want to see more people in this game. So, in the second phase here, Galvus is going to spawn some ghosts that have power pellets on top of them. I actually want to avoid these until the third phase of the fight, because I can eat them as Galvus is spawning in on the third phase, and if I get all three hits, I can cancel him spawning in and have him immediately become vulnerable. So this route I'm going to take might seem a little bit wonky, but it's just a setup for that skip, and this saves about 10 seconds over waiting out the Galvus spawning in. The time's coming up really quickly, so get ready for that. And time. So my timer says 23:02. That is a whopping 46 seconds behind the current world record of 22:16 by me. So that was a pretty solid run overall. Pretty happy with how that went. Again, if you want to learn this game, get in contact with me. I can provide you some resources, including the Pac-Man Speedrunning Discord, which is for all Pac-Man games. We're a very welcoming community. We'd love to have you on board. So that's it for me. I will be doing SM6470-STAR later in this event, but with that, I will throw it back on over to the host.
Thank you so much for the run, and GG.
Thank you. Thanks for having me. See you later.